Hey everybody, welcome back to Super Mario 3D World. In the last video, we cleared World Flower, and then we did this Boss Blitz level. That was kind of a pain. So now that we're done this one, we can actually move on to the next world, and we just need to go over here to start the process. Okay, this is the final world of the game. This is World Crown, and this one has like the most challenging levels of like different types and stuff like that. You have a Toad level, a Captain Toad level, a regular level, and then a mystery house. In this video, we're gonna do the Toad level, and then the mystery house. But first, let's go in here. We can get like a free stamp. Okay, so for getting to World Crown, you get the 8-bit Mario stamp. Okay. I'm wondering which one should I do first. You know what? I'll do the Toad one. That one's interesting. What was that? Oh, I don't even know what that is. Okay. Captain Toad's Fiery Finale is the first level that we're gonna go to in World Crown. Okay, this one is definitely the most difficult of all the Toad levels. It's definitely the easiest one in World Crown, though. The only thing is it's very gamepad heavy, so if there's moments where I'm not talking, it's because I'm trying to like concentrate. And plus, I noticed that if you're talking near the mic, it picks that up, so sometimes that's a problem. Okay, there's a piranha plant, or Venus fire trap, whatever, that's constantly spitting fireballs. You can kill it, I've done it before. But I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do it here. Like, I think you have to bounce back that fireball it spits out. You can use the touchscreen for that, though. You can also grab all the stuff up here, including that stamp. Oh, wait, no, you can't grab the stamp. You have to grab that yourself. Let's see if I can kill him. Like I said, I've been able to kill him. Oh, there we go. And now that he's out of the way, this level is like a little less annoying. But the next thing you have to do is go to the next floating platform here. You can go from here to the next star. The next star is hidden in there, but it's like really risky. If you go in there, like you don't want to stop, and you have to go back to this platform I'm on right now. But you have plenty of time, so you don't really have to do that. Okay. So those blue platforms, you have to blow into the mic. Oh, I I didn't mean to do that. Okay, but that's pretty much the gist of the level. That part is like, once you get past that part, the rest of the level isn't too bad. And like I said, you can get rid of that that fire trap, so I'd probably recommend it if you can. It's kind of tricky sometimes, but it's easier when he spits out that fireball. If you like quickly tap it, it'll go right back to him. See if I can do it. There we go. That's risky though. I don't know if I'd recommend doing that. Oh shoot, I didn't time that right. Okay, now this time I'm hopefully not going to fall in the lava again. Okay, that part, it's kind of hard to talk and do that. And I totally messed up. Okay, I think I should hopefully be able to do it this time. But yeah, that part, it's not easy to talk and play at the same time because you have to blow into the mic. So, yeah, I'm probably going to be quiet from now on. Oh, I missed him. Yeah, if you fall in the lava, it's instant death. You can get hit by one of the fireballs once. It'll make you into small Toad. But anytime after that, you're pretty much dead. Oh, I forgot about the coins up here, too. I should probably grab them, because there's a lot, if you notice, so. There we go. Okay, so now I'm going to wait for this to drop down. There we go. Okay, I did that too early again, but it doesn't matter. Okay, and this is the tricky part. I can't believe I missed that star on those falling blocks, though. Okay, this time I'm not gonna mess up. There we go. Okay, in order to get the stamp, you need to blow that all the way up. Okay, and then we just drop down. And the last star. There we go. Yeah, that took me a few tries, but I got it. It's actually been a while since I played this level. It's actually been a while since I played the game. If you've noticed on my channel, I haven't played, played or uploaded the game in a bit, because my old computer died completely, so this is my very first recording of this game on my new computer, and it seems to be working pretty well. It wasn't that expensive. I had a budget, so I bought this, and you know, it's actually more powerful than my last one, so the prices of computers have dropped down a little bit. And I just bought the desktop. I don't need a monitor because I'm playing on this 42-inch TV that I've had for a while. Anyway, next up is Mystery House Marathon. And if you notice there are 30 stars and a stamp. But the stamp is actually, right at the end. You can't miss it. And I got the stamp there. Okay. Well, here goes nothing. Let's get started with Mystery House Marathon. I'll just stay as Mario, I guess. Okay. The thing is with this one, if you mess up, if you die, you just, lose a life. But if you mess up, then you just get booted back to the very beginning. Okay, you don't have to have any power-ups when you go in here. It helps, but you do get a free, I think there's a Fire Flower and a Cat Suit here. Okay, this part you have to throw these guys on two of the switches, and then step on one yourself. There we go. Since a lot of these are quick, I'll try to explain what to do in some of them, but most of them you probably just have to watch, what I do. Okay, I think this is one. Yeah, this is one with a fire flower. Okay, you just have to light all these torches. There we go. Okay, this one, this room is rotating. You just have to jump over these ghosts here, and then you can grab the star. They disappear. And if you notice, after you grab the star, you still have to get to, the time stops, but you have to grab the star in order for the time to run out. That's what I was trying to say. This one is kind of tricky if you don't know where it is. It's always in this spot right here. Okay. Have to kill all these guys. This one's not too bad. The Micro Goombas can be annoying, but yeah, if you have the Fire Flower, it helps. This one's easy. Once they move out of the way, just throw the baseball. That's it. You don't have to jump or anything either. Okay, this one, you want to destroy all these guys, and then this last one, you have to ground pound on him. Because if you don't, then you don't go high enough to grab that star. Okay, this one isn't too bad either. There we go. There are some tricky ones coming up soon, including this one right here. You have to ride the skate all the way down, but you have to watch out for these guys. If you run into one of them, then you can't make it. If you notice, there's only 1 second left, and I got there pretty quick. This one can be tricky too. You have to hurry up and grab that bell and jump over here. And you have to make it to the other side before the time runs out. There you go. Sometimes the cat suit works against you, because if you notice, I was grabbing onto the wall. Definitely didn't want to do that. Yeah, this one you just have to climb up as fast as possible to the top here. It's in like the top left corner. Okay, I think there... what is this here? Oh, another one. I'll keep the fire flower. We've seen these before. This one's easy though, there's only four of them, so... there we go. Okay, this one's kind of tricky because if you mess up, then you're gonna fail. They give you just enough time to climb these and grab the star. There you go. Okay, we're about halfway there, I think. This one's pretty easy, you just have to go around the fuzzies. If you're climbing here and you want to drop down like I did, just hit one of the trigger buttons. It makes you drop instantly. Okay, this one is kind of annoying sometimes too because you have to chase the rabbit. Okay, if you can catch him quick like that, it's not bad. But sometimes what he'll do is like, you'll try to cut him off. That's the easiest way to get him, by the way, to cut him off. But sometimes he'll turn around if you like cut him off like from too far. You want to cut him off like pretty close. Not only that, but if you catch him on one of these like speed boost things, then you have to go on that to like grab the star. I failed this one time because I couldn't get the star. Oh shoot. Oh, this one's kind of tricky too. There we go. The very first time I played this, the first time I failed this, I failed on that spring one because I didn't know what to do. But one time, after a few tries, I got to this one and I failed it because I couldn't get to that in time. That was kind of annoying. This one's easy. Just destroy the two piranha plants so you can get to this. Go. They have a bunch of coins down there, but they don't give you enough time to grab all of them. Okay, this one you have to just push the two bullies in here. This is very easy with the cat suit. If you somehow lost it and you have the fire flower still, this is pretty easy as well. Okay, this one is... they try to trick you because you have to ground pound one of these. Oh shoot, I am... almost out of time. There we go. You only want to ground pound the one on the left. These are just like... they trick you. I mean, you could use that and then use the cat suit, but if you don't have the cat suit, you definitely want to use that one. Actually, let's see what this one does. Yeah, that doesn't really help. I mean, you can use the cat suit here too. But just going to the left and climbing up, I think that's a little bit faster. Maybe. Okay, this one's tricky. Okay. I've fallen off there several times. This one's kind of tricky too, you have to step on all their heads. There we go. Oh boy. This one you just have to be quick. You have to throw the bomb at this last part here. Ooh! Okay, I almost failed that one. This one was confusing for me at first. I actually failed this one too because I didn't know what was going on, but you have to kill this last one. There you go. Every enemy has to be destroyed in that one. Okay. You know what? I think this one's easier if you have the fire flower, because you can destroy all the piranha plants, but you don't need it. Okay, this one you just have to hurry up and grab this before all the blocks are destroyed. Alright, three more. There we go. That's that one. We have two more now. Okay, this might be the very first time I got hit. I was gonna say the very first time I beat this in one try. Because usually it takes me at least three or four. As long as I don't mess up here. Okay, here's the stamp. Like I said, it's like in the way, so. There we go. That's all 30 stars, and that one gets very crazy. Alright. Okay, so if you notice, we're only missing, what, like five, I think? So yeah, if you notice, a lot of the people that posted for this one posted the star stamp because that's what you get. So that it's definitely, you know, something cool you could post to show that you beat this one. I actually posted one myself. If you have a Miiverse account, you can see that. It's nothing special, but I did it like before this one, before this run, I should say. Okay, but the next level is the last level of the game that we're going to do, Champions Road. That's going to be its own video. I'm trying to decide what I want to do with that level. You know, there's a couple ideas that I have, but for now, that's the end of this video. We got two levels done in World Crown, and then in the next video, we're going to finish up with Champions Road, and then that's probably going to be it, unless there's like a bonus video or something that I think of, but this is probably going to be the last one. Alright everybody, thank you for watching, and look out for the next video whenever that's up, whenever I have time. Alright, see you later everybody.